Now, a clip of Vice President Kamala Harris from earlier this year has resurfaced in the wake of six Israeli hostages being murdered by Hamas in tunnels under Rafah. And as usual, Kamala had it terribly wrong.
We have been clear in multiple conversations and in every way that any major military operation in Rafah would be a huge mistake. Let me tell you something. I have studied the maps. There's nowhere for those folks to go. And we're looking at about 1.5 million people in Rafah who are there because they were told to go there, most of them. And so we've been very clear that it would be a mistake to move into Rafah with any type of military operation.
She studied the maps, James. How could she expect to bring any sort of meaningful change, peace to the Middle East when she appears to be falling for Hamas propaganda?
Well, I mean, Rita, it's not just Kamala Harris, it's Joe Biden. You know, the president, still notionally the president, apparently, you know, her whole administration that she's been involved in for the past nearly 4 years has been basically compromised. You know, they talk a strong game about Israel. Oh, you know, we back Israel and all of this. But, you know, they have, since the very time they came into office, they've been running the Obama foreign policy, which is to appease and embiggen Iran. And that's exactly what's happened. You know, Iran is Hamas's sponsors. Hamas did not want them going into Rafah because that was their HQ where they held all the hostages underneath the city in the terror tunnels that they used all their aid money from the West to go and build instead of giving the Palestinian people infrastructure and food and jobs and an economy. So, you know, really, I'm afraid Kamala Harris there was running the Hamas line. And we have seen the Biden administration also run the Hamas line. And I'm terrified that if Kamala Harris does wind up falling over the line and becoming president, the United States will be much more friendly to Iran and much less friendly to Israel. What you just played there is just a small part of this much bigger and, I think, much more sinister puzzle, Rita.
Absolutely. And you do wonder how committed she is to the Iranian nuclear deal. That was Obama's brainchild. Biden tried to reinvigorate it. And all it has done is embolden and enrich the Iranian regime after 4 years where they were really demoralized under the Trump administration.
Absolutely right. And that Iran deal that Obama started, you know, the whole point of that was to strengthen Iran. It was to normalize relationships with Iran, balance out Sunni power, you know, the Saudis and the Sunni states and the Gulf states, and also balance Israel. You know, this was the most disloyal thing we could have done to one of our allies, Israel. And we saw during the Trump administration how during the Abraham Accords, the relations were normalized between Israel and the Sunni states. You know, this was a great thing for peace. And yet, you know, when Obama was in power and under Biden as well, the demonstrations for peace and democracy in Iran, the people don't want this regime, but, you know, they're saddled with it and they should get some more help from the West.
It is just an appalling abandonment of our ally Israel, the only democracy in the Middle East, but also it's an abandonment of the Iranian people. We've had these mass protests there, so many innocent lives are lost, and the US government almost siding with the Iranians, even if they're not coming out and saying that, their policies are, as I said, emboldening and enriching that regime. Now, to your home city, New York, you had 7,000 protesters there storming the city on Labor Day, some in the crowd waving Hamas flags along with Palestinian, Syrian, Iranian and Hezbollah banners, chanting Free Palestine and resistance is justified when people are occupied. James, were these protests to occur as we discovered the hell those hostages, including an American citizen, endured before they were executed? I mean, it's just beyond the pale.
Look, it's just bizarre. And I mean, I think it goes beyond any sort of support for Palestine or the Palestinian people or peace, because these people certainly don't want peace. I think these people here that you're seeing, these basically you know, Hamas and Intifada cosplayers here walking through the streets of Manhattan. I think I know exactly where that block is there. You know, I've walked up and down those streets a million times in my life. And it's just grim. It's stupid. But I think most of all, it's nihilistic. You know, I think that the point here is really they are just so anti-everything, anti-the-West, anti-Israel, anti-life, anti-anything positive and beautiful and joyful. I think it's a really grim scene to see so many young people throw their lot in with these folks.
It is, but where is the condemnation from authorities? We did have the White House release a statement, but if you had extreme right protesters marching with flags of terrorist groups, waving banners of Hitler or the like, you would expect a bit more action and a bit more outrage from authorities. But these protesters really have been allowed to run riot across the US and across many cities right here in Australia. They've had encampments, they've had all sorts of protests where they've intimidated people going about their business, particularly if they're visibly Jewish. How are we tolerating this in the West?
Well, Rita, I mean, look, for a long time we had a rule and it was set by the left. And the rule was, hey, if a Nazi shows up to your rally, it's a Nazi rally. Now, all of a sudden, you've got these rallies here, which are absolutely filled with people who are spouting the worst sort of anti-Semitic, not anti-Zionist or anti-Israel rhetoric, anti-Jewish hate. They're spewing it. I mean, that's what these terrorist flags are all about, is, you know, wanting to kill the Jews and Westerners, too. All of us are in the frame, by the way. Let's not think that we're spared, even if you're not Jewish. This is a pro-terrorist rally, what we just saw here. This deserves to be condemned by everybody, left and right. And, you know, they should be treated the same way that back in, you know, once upon a time, the Ku Klux Klan or the American Nazi Party wanted to march in Illinois. And the ACLU supported them because they said, you know what, free speech is important, so the Nazis have a right to march. But just as important, everybody came out to condemn them. And that's exactly what needs to happen here, you know, because right now we've got these people who literally, what have we been seeing for months now? Oh, hey, we're so anti-fascist and we want to fight fascism that we're going to go down the street and we're going to smash the glass of Jewish businesses? Yeah, okay, tell me how that works.
They literally call Jews Nazis as they're marching along, as they're intimidating innocent people. I mean, it's almost beyond parody, but you can't laugh at this stuff because it's deadly serious. James Morrow, thank you for your time, and I'll see you Sunday morning for Outsiders.
See you Sunday, Rita.